People are being set free through the training program and the New Life Evangelistic Center. Robert's joining me. How did coming into New Life Evangelistic Center help you to break the cycle?
Well, it got me off drugs. I was able to get a phone. I was able to get back on my medicine correctly and become closer to God.
Where were you located at when you were in the training program?
I was in Marshfield.
And that helped you get closer to God?
Yes, I run the free store.
Uh-huh.
And I read my Bible every day.
So now you got a place to stay.
Yes.
And you're reaching out and wanting to help other homeless people, is that right?
Yes, sir.
The Lord is truly good, isn't he?
He is.
And there's so many that continue to remain out on the streets. I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I mean, that's what's referred to as a Veterans Coming Home Center. It's a day center for the New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield. We're going to go to Mark at this particular time.
We know that Jesus gave service to the entire universe. He gave his life to the entire universe. But there are people, men and women, who are called to give service to a country. And Don has done that. You are a veteran.
Yep, Desert Storm and Desert Shield.
Okay. So we thank Jesus for his contribution in helping us find freedom.
Absolutely.
Right? But you also fought for our country for freedom.
Yes.
What war did you fight in?
Desert Storm, Desert Shield, Iraq.
Why did you go?
Because I felt the call. I was at a young age. My dad's military, ex-military, ex-Navy, and it's kind of the way I grew up, you know. And you know, a good patriot, you at least go and you know, serve your country when they need you.
Well, you know, we have people today who would not give their lives for even the closest friends or even some of their own relatives. But you actually went into combat to give your life for this country.
Yeah, I mean, it's putting others before yourself and taking a bullet for them. That's what love's all about. It's what Jesus did for us when he came down. So as a human being, if you can't do that, then, you know.
Okay, so it's actually being selfless.
Selfless, exactly. Putting others before yourself. That's what love is, I think.
Okay. So tell me about the combat you went in to. What did you go through? What was your worst period of that combat?
I was a combat controller, so what I did is we did strategic airstrikes. So I was the guy that went in and pointed the little laser at the building through the coordinates so they could less civilian casualties. So I thought that was pretty noble job to do, and did it as soon as it kicked off in Desert Storm. Was over there and right in the middle of it, did two tours over there.
Did you lose any friends?
A lot of friends, yes. The first barracks that got hit over there, I don't know if you remember, the Air Force barracks that got hit, had three friends that died in that, so, yeah.
How do you deal with that today?
I know they're in a better place than I'm in because they were all, you know, had faith, and that's what keeps you going. I mean, I'm looking forward to God coming back, so.
Don, when you came back after your service, what happened to you?
I came back. It was a little difficult, you know, getting back into the civilian world, but after that, it's been good. I've been working at the same place here for 8 years. They shut down during the first round of COVID. That's when I became homeless, and then they're back up and running. They're trying to get me to come back to work, but I'm giving the art thing and dry before I go punch a time clock. And I got the gallery coming up tonight for a first walk at Bookmarks, and hopefully that does good because I'm going through a program called Home at Last. All I have to do is come with my deposit, and then they're going to pay my rent for up to a year because of my service.
Okay. Because of your service.
Yeah.
Right. I think we should really honor our veterans. Right. They shouldn't come home and be homeless. They shouldn't come home and be in poverty. They shouldn't come home and be in fear. They should be coming home and want. Right. So I'm glad. Now, how close are you to getting all the deposit money together?
Hopefully after tonight we'll be real close, and I'll sell some paintings because I don't want to.
You're an artist.
Yes. I don't want to. Yeah. the art walk first Friday. I'm going to be at Bookmarks tonight at 6 p.m.
Okay.
Hopefully I'll sell some oil paintings. It was about 16 pieces, and they're all biblically themed.
Right. So Don invited me to go, and I said, "Well, I'll go." And I said, "Maybe I'll buy a painting." He goes, "Well, they're kind of expensive."
Couldn't afford it.
So I asked him to take a check, and he said,
"No, no check. I went to the cash."
No checks.
No checks.
Okay. So what does Jesus Christ mean to you?
He's everything. I obey. I put him first before anything in this world. And when he was here, it was all about love. He broke bread with the lepers. He broke bread with the sinners. And I just out here, and while I'm out here, I try to shine a light on people best I can. If I have something they need, I always carry a big bag full of stuff, you know, and try to help out while I'm here. If someone's scared to sleep alone, like female, I had one come through here. She was a veteran with the two dogs. You probably remember her. And a couple nights she was out there. I had her safe place to sleep and watch over. That's kind of what I'm doing out here.
So you're still serving.
Got me here. Yeah,
right, God, you're still serving. Here for, but now you're in a different war for the kingdom of God, right?
Absolutely.
Tell me about the COVID.
There's mixed opinions on that, but I've lost some people that I knew here recently close to it. That's why I always wear a mask. And whether, you know, you choose to get the vaccination or not, depending on what your opinion is, the medical research is still out on that. Wear a mask, I mean, because it blocks the virus. I mean,
have you been vaccinated? Have you been
vaccinated? No. And for my own reasons, I won't. But I'll wear a mask because I don't want to get it. And I don't want other people to get it.
Or give it to anybody else.
Yeah, it's real. And I wouldn't want to be responsible for, you know, someone's grandpa or grandma dying because I spread the virus.
Okay. So how's America treated you since you come back?
Very well. I mean, there are a lot of good programs. Again, God's got me here for a reason. I probably could have sped up the process and be in a place right now, but he's got me, you know, touching people and helping people while we're out here, and they can't fend for themselves pretty much. So
let's bring it home. You're here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. What does it mean to you?
This is my refuge, man. This is a place when I'm up all night. This is a place to kick back, sleep, watch a movie, just kind of take a breath, and paint. I do a lot of painting here, too. And I will clean my messes up from now on. But it's just a place to get off the street. And it's kind of an oasis, so to speak.
Right. Now, we call this the Veterans Coming Home Center. There are several other veterans also that are here.
Yes.
Right? Okay, so I don't know if we'll make it to your gallery today, tonight, right? But if we do, we're going to show some of your pictures.
Okay? Right on, I appreciate
some of your drawings.
Okay? I appreciate that. That's
awesome. We appreciate you being the best part of the Veterans Coming Home Center.
Just God being here and that theme first, and putting him first before anything, praying before your food, no matter how many people don't like it, too bad, because this is Jesus is what it's all about.
What do you think about us having a little devotion in the morning now?
I think that's good. Can I tell you my prayer I say every morning?
Yes.
This is the day our Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. And I say that every morning when I wake up. It's short, it's simple, but it reminds you you're breathing. Right. And God knows your name, and that should be enough.
Right, and it's important to wake up with God on your mind. There's a song called I Woke Up This Morning With My Mind Stayed On Jesus. It's just like people get up in the morning and they say, oh, I'm going to have bacon, I'm going to have eggs, I'm going to have pancakes with maple syrup and everything, and I'm going to, I'm just so hungry, right? But we forget to feed the spiritual man.
Yeah, but you got to have that manna. You got to have that fresh manna every day.
And the fresh manna comes from?
It comes from the Word.
That's right. The Word of God. The Word of God is that food for that spiritual body that you have. Only it will make it strong, make your spiritual person strong, so you can stand up against the devil, so you can stand up and have victory in your life.
I'm actually a converted Hebrew, so I know a little bit about the Bible, but I also know who my Messiah is, too.
Okay. Well, I want to thank you for being the best part of the Veterans Coming Home Center. We want to thank you again for your service, not only to our country, but to his kingdom.
And thank you guys very much. Thank God, first and foremost. Thank you guys for what you do. You help a lot of people out here, whether they appreciate it or not. I'll let you know it's much appreciated. And thank you for putting God first. That's the biggest thing.
Okay. Well, thank you.
I appreciate it.
Joe is being set free from the cycle of homelessness. He's a part of the Outreach of New Life Evangelistic Center. He helps. What are some of the things that you do here, Joe?
Okay, some of the things I do is I help make sure everything's picked up and that we have a peaceful area.
Yes, and you also, you pick up donations, you bring them in, you help around here. What does it mean to you to be able to help other people?
Well, being a veteran myself and on staff here is quite an experience. But to help other vets and other people is a calling, and I've been called to do this by the Lord, not by me, not by Larry Rice, not by Chris Rice or anybody else. The Lord has called me to do this.
Hallelujah. And that gives you the strength to keep on keeping on, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Amen.
We do have some very severe needs here.
Yes.
Our men's clothes is down to 2%.
We need a lot more men's clothing, is that right?
That's right. Large men and smaller men like myself, we need clothes. And those of you folks that are here in Springfield, please remember that these people are needing a helping hand, a hand up, not a hand out.
You can do that. That is actually an opportunity for you to reach out and help in so many different ways. It's 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, and those of you in the greater St. Louis area, 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. He's brought out a great need for men's clothing. We can't ever get enough men's clothing, so please help in that way. A lot of people in need in there.
Also, we have other needs here too, you know, like supplies.
Yes.
You know, like toilet paper, paper towels, napkins, plates, you know, stuff that we use a lot of every day.
Every day, feeding 150 people.
Well, yeah, it's averaging to about 150 people a day.
Mm-hmm. We need all those items.
And some of the bigger donors have kind of backed off a little bit.
Yes, it's summertime. They've gone on vacation. They've gone on vacation with their need. The needs continue here. 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri.
And if you can volunteer, we need volunteers all the time.
Yes, please contact them here.
Yep, at 866-336-3363.
All right, let's do that again. Area code 417, and for volunteers, what's the number again?
866-336-3363.
All right, please give us a call. Let's go back to Mark.
I'm joined here with William, and William, you're also a veteran.
Yes, sir.
How did you serve our country?
I was in the Army for 8.5 years serving Desert Storm.
Desert Storm. Tell me about Desert Storm. What did you do there?
I was a combat engineer. Went in and checked for landmines and set up security for pretty much the ground troops.
Now, you know, I never actually served in the Army. But I know that people who have served in the Army go through all kinds of danger, life-threatening danger. Can you tell us a story that where you felt your life was threatened?
We were on a convoy, and an RPG was fired at me. It hit the side of my truck and embedded in the side of my truck without detonating. It was pretty scary.
Okay. Now, you came back to our country after Desert Storm, right?
Yes.
And what did you encounter when you came back?
Well, at the time I was going through a divorce and had lost my home due to financial problems going through the divorce.
Were you welcomed as a hero when you came back?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Was the Veteran Administration there to help you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you were not homeless when you came home?
No.
Okay.
Never been homeless until I came to Springfield, Missouri.
Okay. What happened in Springfield?
I got some legal problems, which I was in the housing I was in. If you have any kind of charges against you, you couldn't stay there, so I got evicted.
Okay. How long you been homeless?
For a year and a half.
Year and a half. Tell me, now you served the country, you served in Desert Storm. And now you're going through a whole nother war, a whole nother struggle. How's it been for you?
It's been really rough. It's been really rough. It's hard to get to where I need to go. It's hard to find what I need when I need it sometimes, but I just keep trooping along.
What help do you need right now?
Well, right now I'm in a sober living program, so I'm being pretty well taken care of, so... But bus passes, clothes, different things y'all help provide for us.
Okay. So how did you hear about the Veterans Coming Home Center?
I've known about it since they've opened it. I've been around here, so.
Okay. So you knew about it before you actually became homeless?
Yes, right. For years before then.
Okay. Well, we're glad to service you. We thank you again for your service to our country, right? And we're going to keep you in prayer. How long before you actually are stable enough to have a roof over your head again?
I'm hoping within the next 3 to 4 months.
Okay, 3 or 4 months. Well, we're going to be here for you. We're going to keep you in prayer. We're going to give you some bus tickets so you can get around.
All right. I appreciate that.
Again, we thank you for your service to our country, and we thank you for your service to the kingdom.
And I very much appreciate all service to help people.
That's what we're here for. We're working to be here when people are hurting. So we thank you.
Yeah, they fed me. They've clothed me. They've taken real well care of me.
Okay. We thank you for being here. Peter Garcelon, you also are a veteran.
Yes, I am.
But I want to start with the good news first. Right? You came to me, I was walking past here, and tell me the great, great news.
The great news was that yesterday I was in the library and I led three people to the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That's the greatest news, right? Because we are in a war.
Yes, we are.
We are in a war against Satan. Right?
Yes,
who wants to kill, steal, and destroy us.
That's right.
And so when we have, and this is what the main purpose of this center is, it's not so much the laundry, it's not so much the library or the food or the clothing room, right? And all the other services we provide is to show the love of God so that love can be used by God to win souls.
Amen.
Right? So we're happy to hear that souls were won.
Yes.
Right, in this battle. Yes. Right? Now, you're a veteran. Where'd you serve?
I served over in Germany, Augsburg, Germany, for 2 years. And after I got back to the United States and stuff, I lived in Florida, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, for quite some time. And then we moved to the Bahamas.
Okay. So you say we. Who's we?
Me and my whole family.
Okay.
And my father's a fisherman.
Uh-huh.
And we just traveled around and done a lot of traveling from Maine to Florida, from Florida back to Maine.
What made you want to give your life, lay down your life for this country? Why?
When I went to prison, I was a drunk, I was a drug addict, and I couldn't save me. There was nothing I could do by my own strength to save myself. So I cried out to the Lord, and I said, Lord, you're going to have to teach me how to love again. You're going to have to teach me how to serve you properly and be the kind of disciple that you want me to be. And so I became an evangelist. I started going around just all over the place, just passing out pamphlets and just praising the Lord and teaching people that God loves them. And it's really hard at times because your heart gets broken when they turn away from you and they walk away from you and they don't want to hear God's word. That really hurts. And we just got to keep pressing on and pressing on and pressing on. We cannot give up because God loves his children. He really does.
He does love his children.
His creation.
And I remember a song called We Are Soldiers. We are soldiers in the army.
Yep.
We have to fight, although we have to die. We have to hold up the bloodstained banner. We have to hold up until we die. So you served our country. And now you serve the King of Kings.
Yes, I do. And I'll tell you right now, there's nothing greater than serving the King of Kings. Because we've got to come to a place where we understand that everything that we've got, including our breath, the very air that we breathe is from Jesus Christ. It's not, you can't buy Christianity.
That's right.
People have tried. People have, you know, they say, look what I did, Lord. But it's not about them. It's about Jesus Christ and what he's done.
Right. It's not about us.
Right.
And that's what the world is about right now. The world is so selfish and so self-centered that it says it's about us, right? And we live in a disposable world where, you know, if you burn my toast, you're fired. Or you burn my toast, I'm getting a divorce. And it's a disposable world. And we live in a world that's me, 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 right? So how is that different for Christ?
Well, I look at it like this. There are two types of love. There's carnal love and there's agape love. Agape love is I'm going to love you regardless of whether you love me or not. I'm going to continue to love you. And that's the kind of love that God wants us, each one of us, to have. Jesus Christ himself was an example. He went and he washed the feet of his disciples. And he told them that what I have done unto you, you do unto others. That's the kind of love we've got to have. We've got to have unity. We're all brothers and sisters in Christ, and we have to have that unity because by ourselves, we have no strength. We have nothing.
We have no strength. And the Lord's Prayer is our Father, which means we are His children.
Exactly.
Right? I want you to think for a moment. And I'd like you to, can you say a prayer for your brothers and sisters here? And for other veterans too? Will you do it for us?
I sure would. Okay.
You are listening or you are at home. Pray with us.
Dear Heavenly Father, right now I lift everybody in this building up to you, Lord. Lord, we all need you. Every last one of us needs you, Lord. We may not see it at the moment. We've been blinded by Satan. Satan is a liar, a deceiver. He's out to destroy. And we've got to come together as Christians in unity and in brotherhood. And we've got to have a revival that shakes the earth to its very foundation. We got to shake this earth because we need to show people the love of God. The love of God is so beautiful. There's not an ocean deep enough to stop the love of God. You can go to outer space and God is with you. You can go to the deepest part of the sea, God is with you. If you're in prison, don't be discouraged. Stand strong. Believe in the Lord. His angels open the prison doors. He set the captives free, and he wants to do the same thing right now. He wants to free each and every one of us from whatever bondage we are under. He can take it away. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter whether it's drugs, whether it's sex-related. God can free you. God can change your life and make it a better one. And if people would just listen to what I'm saying right now, I solemnly swear to you, God has a plan for your life. He will take you on a journey like you've never been before, and it's going to be a breathtaking journey.
And that is your prayer, and I agree with you 100% for your prayer. I hope that you at home and those who are listening will also agree to that prayer. We need more lives saved for the kingdom of God, and we know we don't do the saving. The Holy Spirit does the saving, but we are messengers to plant that seed.
Yes, we are, and if we'll stand strong, God will do the rest. All we got to do is just spread the seed. And if you really have the love of God in you, you can't do anything but want to go and tell people what Jesus has done. Because when Jesus was on the road to Dominicus, I think it was.
Damascus.
Yeah. Okay. He turned around and he saw a blind man, and the blind man cried out to him. And he healed him. He healed him.
Right. He's come to set the captives free, right? And I want to thank you for, again, your service to our country and to the service to the King. And I want to thank you for the good news. You went right past me and said, hey, I got some good news. Souls are being changed. Lives are being changed. Souls are being saved. Lives are being saved. Here at the Veterans Coming Home Center, we need you to get involved. We need your prayers. If you cannot donate, donate through the time you spend in prayer, right?
Amen.
Okay. Amen. Thank you for being with us today.
Oh, thank you.
Tell us your name.
Andrew McBroom.
Andrew, I understand you need a sleeping bag. Why do you need a sleeping bag?
Oh, never been homeless before, but being on the street is pretty rough and just makes it a little bit easier to sleep and, you know, wake up a little more refreshed in the morning.
So you are homeless right now?
Yes, sir.
And how you don't have a sleeping bag at all?
No, I have a little wool blanket that I sleep on. That's about it.
Well, if people like to volunteer or if they'd like to donate sleeping bags in Springfield, then call 417-866-3363. That's 417-866-3363 in Springfield. In St. Louis, 314-421-3020. Oh, Mark wants to hand you a sleeping bag right there. You want to grab that?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Mark. And also, brother, I want you to know we have a training program, okay?
Mm-hmm.
If you want to totally get off the streets, you can talk to him about that, okay? You can talk to my son, Chris, who's behind the camera over there, about the training program, an opportunity for you to be set free from the cycle of homelessness,
mm-hmm.
be involved in daily Bible studies,
mm-hmm.
grow in Jesus, learn skills, and help the Lord, just let Him just work in you and through you, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he desires to work with you, but he also wants you to just be obedient, follow him, and get in his word. You know that?
As well be done.
You know, because all things, not just some things, work together for good to them who love God and called according to his purpose. How did you ever end up homeless?
My wife and daughter passed away in January. I came down here from Duluth, and a friend kind of stood me up, so I've just been on the street for about a week and a half now.
Devastating, just the loneliness of losing a loved one like that. Living two loved ones like that.
Yeah.
That's why we need to get you into a supportive Christian community. It's so hard out there. I know you're going through so much pain at this moment, okay?
Yeah, it hurts.
I mean, people have no understanding that they've never lost a wife, and particularly a child, too. But at the same time, how did that happen?
Drunk semi-driver on I-94 in Minnesota.
Wow. Hit him like that.
Yeah, back in January.
And that can just cause one to just totally spin out of control. I mean, the devastation, the hurt, the pain, they can start taking up drinking, all kinds of things that make the situation worse.
Yeah, it's hard not to.
Yes, but God loves you. He's got a plan for your life. I want you to pray seriously about the training program the Lord has provided. Will you do that?
Yes, I will.
And my son Chris over here would love to talk to you about it, okay?
All right, appreciate it.
I'm asking you to please pray for so many that are hurting at this time, so many that are in need. And you can partner with us at the New Life Evangelistic Center. As I mentioned, you can get sleeping bags and bring them to 2428 Woodson Road in Overland or 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. If you want to volunteer in the St. Louis area, call 314-421-3020 for further information. And in Springfield, they can also get involved at 417-866-3363, because there's many people like you that are in need, aren't there?
Yes, sir, there is.
Many people in need. And I ask you to please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center as we desire to continue to reach out through the love of Jesus, helping the hurting and helping the homeless.